Yo guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be upgrading and replacing the stock servo of the Traxxas Slash 4x4 with this yellow RC 30kg digital servo. I've already put one of these servos in my XL1, but today we'll be installing it into the Slash. So yeah, let's do that. Part YEL 2075, which we got some screws and stuff, extension cable, and of course the servo. Now, I haven't made a lot of videos lately because I got sick. I've been sick now for 2 weeks, but yeah, maybe you can also hear it from my voice. But hey, I'm still making a video for you guys. And yeah, here it is. So this is my Traxxas Slash 4x4 VXL. I put some upgrades on it already. I haven't really shown it before. I got this unbreakable body, which is based on the Arma Typhon. Rear wing, some fans here, a fan here, lower center of gravity chassis, some front shocks. Yeah, that's about it, I think. Also today I'll be installing this aluminum part, which I wanted to put on the XL1, but it didn't fit, so I got it still. And also I want to stiffen up the rear with these rear springs. So yeah, first we'll be installing the new servo. Okay, so you don't need to do this, but I will be removing the front wheels first. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so we'll be removing these two screws and also these screws. Okay, and then we can just remove the front from the chassis. Just like that. So we'll just remove the screw here. And then we'll be removing the 4 screws on the servo. Okay, I just removed the complete front. So now I'll just remove those 4 screws. And now we can just slide it out, just like that. Now we just have to unplug it from the receiver box and install the new servo. And there we go, we got the old servo out. Now we'll install the new one. First we'll remove this cable. Put it in here. There we go. And I'll first put the 4 screws in here, put it in a receiver, and then center the servo. So let's do that now. There we go, it's in. Now just route the cable. In here. Into the correct channel. There we go. I'll put a LiPo in here and test it out now. Okay, we'll switch it on. It's working. Putting the string trim on zero. There we go. Okay. That's good. Okay, now we got that all working. I'll be installing this part 6845A. So, aluminum drag link in blue. So we are gonna remove these two screws for here and here. And there we have the old one. There we have the old one. There's nothing wrong with this one, but I cut this part lying around, so no, why not? And upgrade it. I haven't really heard if it's a weak spot in the slash or not, but I got it, so no, why not? And there we go. There we go, we put it on. It's nice. I also got the aluminum lower suspension arms, which I put on like a long time ago because they kept on breaking. I know a lot of people don't like aluminum lower suspension arms, but they just kept on breaking, so I just replaced it. It's way better, in my personal opinion. Also put the, I think it's a Rustler front bumper on it, because I'm rocking a different body and it fits, right? It looks better in my opinion. But yeah, let's now install the front back onto the car. Now I'll be putting the receiver box back on, or the top, and make sure all the wires are not stuck in here. I'll be doing that off camera, it's boring, whatever. So yeah. Okay, so now I've done that. Now I have to screw in the steering parts. How is it called? I don't know. But anyway, we're gonna put the screw in here. Then put the four screws here and here. And that should be all. And also, I need to put the drive shaft in the correct place. I'll do it off camera because it can be quite frustrating sometimes. So yeah. Okay, got that done. So now let's put the wheels back on. Oh, and also need to put the wires for the front lights back on. Okay, I did that now. Let's switch it on. Damn, those lights are brighter than my future. Okay, that's a little bit better. Yeah, seems to be working perfectly. That's great. Not the fastest, but it's way stronger. Yeah, nice. Now we'll just put the rear springs on 6868. So let's do that. Okay, I'm gonna remove the shocks completely because I also want to check if there's any oil in there left. Because one time I crashed and lost a part, replaced it, but it's really soft. Gonna just check real quick. And see what is up. And of course, if I replace the springs, that will be a bit stiffer. But yeah, I still want to check if there's any oil left. Okay. Oh, there's a little bit of oil, but it's almost bone dry in there. Yeah, you cannot really see it. You have to trust me, it's dry. So I'll be topping it off with new fresh oil. Also do it for the other one and replace the springs. Okay, so I put them on and they're definitely a lot stiffer now. I put oil in this shock. This one, it was still full, so that's good. I got the old shocks here. You can see they're dirty, they're used. These ones, the blue stripe, they claim to be 20% stiffer, I think. Yeah, that's great. And that's all for today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please subscribe. Look at all my other videos. So yeah, subscribe, like, whatever. Goodbye.